Welcome back to a sun-drenched Hillsborough. Leeds United trying so hard to bring back those glory days of the late 60s and early 70s when Billy Bremner was a player, but now the players he managed have a 1-0 half-time lead against Coventry City. Adams. Leeds began the match so brightly and they're trying to do the same at the start of the second half. Sheridan. So the goal from David Rennie after 14 minutes, and he's not in the team in second division matches at the moment because Mark Hazlewood has been signed from Charlton Athletic, who's not eligible for the FA Cup. Borrows. Far too close to the goalkeeper, the cross. Billy Bremner down on the touchline for the second half. An extraordinary FA Cup semi-final record as a player. He scored the winning goal in semi-finals for Leeds on three occasions. But his team, having taken the lead and dominating the early phases of the game, have found Coventry a handful since then. Clipped forward by Downs. Supporters are massed, or most of them, some 20,000 Sky Blue fans on the Hillsborough Kop. Pickering. Bennett. Leeds couldn't push out quickly enough to play him offside, but they needn't have worried because the attempt to reach the players beyond the far post was unsuccessful for David Bennett. So the Coventry fans on the Kop, the opposite end from the quarter-final, and the club was successful here. But Leeds United have been specialists on Sundays in this competition. They won in the third round against Telford, of course. Publicity, not all the right kind, surrounding that game. They were scheduled to play Swindon in the fourth round on a Sunday, and that was postponed, in fact, and they beat Wigan in the quarter-finals on a Sunday. John Sheridan presiding over the free kick. Borrows trying to hold off Styles. McGrath. And Pickering was aware that there was a player outside him, Mouchin. But Pickering, in fact, taking his eye off the ball. Didn't see a tackle coming either. And he was down hurt for a second. And play on. Baird. Surely not. Sheridan trying to explain to Downs exactly what had happened. Maybe there was a word of apology in there as well, because it was, in the end, a foul against the Leeds player. It's a match you daren't take your eye off. Styles. Should have been told, and Styles hadn't helped Dave Rennie initially, and then they went for the same ball, and Leeds were able to deal with the problem. Mickey Adams played for both sides this season, and playing here in his hometown of Sheffield, where he used to be a Sheffield United fan. Sheridan.
Right.
right in the six-yard box to try and distract Agrizovic. It's wasted by Adams on that occasion. 10 minutes gone. 35 minutes left. That's really the key statistic. It will seem like a lifetime for Leeds United. It will seem like 5 minutes for Coventry. If it stays the same, that is. Hillsborough's first FA Cup final since 1981. Perfect theatre, really, for a match of this substance. Aspen penalised for spot of obstruction. In from Phillips. Bennett. Difficulty for Day in the end was that the ball took rather a low bounce from a fairly gentle header from the player who played for Manchester City against Spurs at Wembley in 1981. Well, if Leeds are using up a little bit of time, who can blame them? By Regis until Adams stepped in.
I think there's a big danger that Coventry could get anxious, Martin, and try to hit the front people too early. Bennett was having a little bit of joy when he was combining with
Baird. Richie. There were three defenders around him. The odds were against him. And the referee decided that Richie was initially obstructing before he was pushed in the back. It was a decision that could have gone either way. Coventry have been away this week. Typical build-up for a big match down in Bournemouth, where they regard it as their lucky hotel. Well, they need a spot of luck now, or maybe a touch of inspiration, or perhaps a defensive error to get back into the game, which they've been chasing since David Rennie's header in the 14th minute. Pearson, who's given responsibility at long throws and corners for marking the space there around the near post, the tallest of the Leeds players. He's waiting there again as Bennett places the ball for the corner. Out from Stiles. Richie, and neat interplay with Baird. Leeds on the charge here. Sheridan. Baird charging about up front like a steamroller, and the ball dropping his way again. There's much more deftness in his touch these days, Ian Baird. Ron Atkinson was making the point in the first half, and I'm sure that John Pearson's arrival, and Pearson hasn't been scoring goals since he came here from Charlton, but Baird just can't stop scoring. He's moved on to 17 this season. He's scored in each of the cup ties in which he's played. He missed the quarter-final through suspension. He played a part in winning the free kick, but Adams leads for Sheridan, who can do a lot better than that.